Hi, I'm Greg Pavlik, Senior Vice President for Data and AI Services at Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. Today we're going to be talking about how data lakehouses are the next generation of analytics platforms. And we're going to talk a bit about what we're doing here at OCI to make the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure the best place for building your lakehouse solution. So we're going to look at three things today. We're going to look at how OCI data services work together to form an integrated platform for your lakehouse solution. Second, we're going to be talking about the range of investments we've been making across open source projects and enabling them through native cloud services, and investments we've been making in our autonomous data warehouse to support the lakehouse. Lastly, we're going to look at how our customers are using the lakehouse today. You're going to see actual lakehouse solutions in action, using the platform services that we're talking about in today's discussion. And you're going to see how you can move forward with building your own lakehouse today. You don't have to wait for any kind of future deliverables. This is a real platform opportunity that you can take advantage of today. So let me give you a little bit of background here to motivate where we're going. I think we all know that the world is now, it's more connected and more automated than ever. And really, to drive new business value, customers need to be able to exploit the new sources of data that are generated from this connected world, right? We're talking about things like social media feeds, sensor data, video, sound, images, et cetera, right? So customers need to be able to work with all types of data, their traditional relational data sets, but also these new types of data. They need to be able to ensure that it's available to be used and combined together, and they need to be able to do this at scale. So for example, if you think about traditional supply chain management, the main signals that people looked at were things like inventory, demand, and order management. That's not enough today. Today, a manufacturer may need to understand how global weather patterns are going to affect their supply chains. Or, separate example, most businesses need to pull in data from as many social media sources as possible to understand how customer sentiment impacts product sales and corporate brands. So our customers need a data platform that can ensure that all this different type of data can be brought together and can work together both seamlessly but also easily. So today, if you look at this circle here, what it represents is the traditional analytic data sets that we're all familiar with, that have really, we have the most mature tools and platforms for dealing with. This is your existing data from relational systems, your existing data from your applications, typically brought together in a data warehouse. However, as you go out from the center of the circle, we have newer types of data, right? This is things like semi-structured data, maybe invoices or forms from which you derive name value pairs to do further processing on. Or if you go all the way out to the outer circle, your unstructured data, maybe it's images, video. There's information embedded there, but it's not information that's structured in a way that a traditional relational system can manage. So as you get out further in these dimensions, what you find is that this is really where additional signals, additional sources of data that give you truly differentiated outcomes for your business exist. But it's also where there's been a gap in terms of the tools and platforms that are required to exploit the data effectively. One other thing to note about these newer data sources, especially the unstructured data, if you want to exploit this data, this is where artificial intelligence, AI, becomes critical. Right? You need things like highly accurate text, video, and image AI. Why? Well, let me give you an example. If you want to be able to work with the data that's embedded in, say, an image in a scanned form, you need to be able to interpret that with both image analysis and textual AI to pull the content of the image that you can then process and make sense of within the context of your analytics solution. So bringing all this data together, being able to join it to answer new questions, that's the promise that big data was supposed to deliver on. But it hasn't always been easy. So many enterprises wound up with even more silos as they tried to invest in big data solutions. So let's take a look at how the space evolved and how this kind of happened to introduce even more silos unintentionally. So we started out, as I noted earlier, with these rich transactional data sets that were managed in data warehouses. The data warehouse was created at a time when that was the primary source of data, almost the exclusive source of data, and analyzing that structured data by itself was sufficient to drive quite a bit of business insight. Then these data lakes came along, and the data lakes were all about giving us ways to store and manage the semi and unstructured data at low cost and at scale. This coincided with a whole plethora of open source projects, an open source ecosystem, which created these projects to not just store the data, but to process it, process these new data types at scale. The problem is customers often wound up with largely parallel worlds. So you would have your data warehouse on the one hand, and then adjacent to it, you'd have a data lake. They'd run side by side, but they'd have different tools. They'd have silos of information. It was hard to reconcile information across the systems, let alone ask questions that needed to be answered by joining them. So Oracle's solving that problem. We're consolidating our data management for analytics around a platform we call Lakehouse. It brings the best of both of these worlds together into a unified architecture that lets you manage and query all types of data together. So our Lakehouse architecture has six major functional areas you can see in the center here. So let me start, I'll walk you through the major components within the Lakehouse architecture. So first are the most popular open source tools for data management. And these are delivered as services, as native cloud services within OCI. These include things like support for the Apache Hadoop ecosystem, Apache Spark, OpenSearch, and more. Second, our data warehouse services, right? And these are the rich analytic capabilities that we put over transactional data, traditional relational data sets. Customers on OCI have a choice of using our Oracle Autonomous data warehouse or our MySQL HeatWave open source data warehousing technology. Third, we have data stores that are optimized for your data type within the Lakehouse. So if you're using these semi-structured or unstructured data types, you can build data lakes on the object store, and we're optimizing for that use case. And if you have relational data sets that you're putting inside the Lakehouse, those will be within relational stores that make query access extremely fast and extremely efficient. The fourth area is we have a unified way to define all the data within Lakehouse, all data, all types, within the OCI data catalog. We can put the table descriptions and metadata all within a single catalog for the entire Lakehouse architecture. Fifth, we have data movement support so that you can move your data based on the workload and task at hand. This makes it really easy to get your data into the Lakehouse, and it makes it easy to ensure that your data is available in an optimal form for the specific needs of your application. Six, and I think I can't emphasize the importance of this enough, we are bringing intelligence to all of this, meaning we are bringing AI solutions into the Lakehouse so you can understand and make sense of your data. So our Lakehouse will make it easier for you to build your own AI solutions, do your own data science and machine learning workloads, or you can use our pre-built AI services to make sense of your unstructured data. So a key part of the architecture. So to get started with the Lakehouse, we have three main paths on OCI, and we're going to talk about those today. So let me tell you what they are real quick, and then we'll drill down into each of them. First of all, you can build new data lakes, or you can move existing data lakes from on-premise or other clouds easily into OCI. Second, you can extend your OCI data warehouse transparently and with no coding changes into a Lakehouse architecture. And then third, we'll talk about mechanisms to build intelligent SaaS analytics on top of a Lakehouse. So if you're using Oracle applications or in combination with third-party applications or your own bespoke applications, you can bring all that data together in a Lakehouse easily and begin to get value out of it quickly. So the key thing here is with each of these paths, our customers can start easily from where they are today And in many cases, they can do it without writing any new code at all. So within each path, we'll talk about the investments we're making as well. So you can see some of the, through the announcements that we're going to talk about today, some of the technical enablers for the Lakehouse that are available to get started with. So let's talk a little bit about that first path, right, where we have customers moving their data lakes into OCI or building a data lake from scratch. Okay, so many customers have built out a data lake, oftentimes very expensive. If you think about the traditional Hadoop architecture, you have to put up a large investment, a large capital investment in hardware, keep these clusters running all the time, a lot of care and feeding. So they're expensive to manage on-premise. And if you replicate that same architecture in many of the competitive clouds, it can be even more expensive. So what we're doing here in part is make it very easy to move those data lakes to OCI. So you can dramatically reduce the total cost of ownership of your investment overall, not only for running the workloads that you have in terms of your data lakes today, but also reducing things like egress charges around data access within the platform. So we're making this easy. And one of the things we're doing and one of the things we're announcing today is we can help you get your data at scale into OCI with a new partnership with WANdisco. Now, we're also introducing new capabilities to make it easier to migrate or build your data lake within OCI proper, right? Using your existing open source skills and tools. So you don't have to change investments, you don't have to do major rewrites. So the first big announcement we have is a major update to our Hadoop-based big data service, or what we call BDS. BDS now is running its own Hadoop distribution, which is optimized for OCI. So it lets us take the best of the open source ecosystem and optimize it for the cloud, getting deep into the internals of OCI to make your solutions run faster and cheaper. We've also introduced new capabilities on our Dataflow serverless Spark service. So Dataflow allows you to run Apache Spark jobs in a purely serverless mode. Very easy to do batch workloads, as close to zero ops, zero overhead as possible. You tell it what job you want to run, what data you want to touch, how much processing you want to use, and the system within tens of seconds is up and running your big data workload at scale, your batch job at scale. Okay. Dataflow, we're introducing a new serverless Spark SQL capability. This is sophisticated OLAP indexes that allow you to make very fast queries over your data lake. So you can get rich interactive analytics with your tool of choice over your data lake with none of the complexities that come with managing clusters or having to do all the care and feeding of a big data infrastructure. So if you pair this up with our autonomous data warehouse or with our MySQL HeatWave, it really gives you everything you need within the Lakehouse architecture to prepare and run analytics over top of all your data. So now let's take a look at a video on how Experian has created their Lakehouse on OCI. Experian's using our latest open source services to migrate and consolidate their data lakes from both other clouds and from on-premise.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Mervyn Lally, and I'm Chief Enterprise Architect at Experian. Experian is a global financial services company. We've got approximately 18,000 employees in 44 countries. We serve consumers all over the world. We serve billions of consumers with credit information to help them on their journey through life. We also support many of the large financial institutions and in the financial ecosystem. We want to be inclusive, not only as a company and how we employ people, but also how our products work and how our products can be financially inclusive in the marketplace. That means data, new data sets, different data sets become increasingly important to giving our consumers a very inclusive environment. Classic example for that for me is you're in the middle of a mortgage application. So for example, if you pay off your credit card, you want to be able to see a rapid rescore of your credit rating. You don't want to wait 30 days for a traditional update to happen. You want that transaction to be included in your next financial decision that you've made. At Experian, we use significant amounts of data and turn them into insights to help people on the journey. The biggest challenges that led us to Data Lakehouse was we wanted an open data platform that consisted of open source products and services that allowed us to build vast data pipelines, process large amounts of data, including real-time events, including traditional databases. We need an end-to-end cloud infrastructure that allowed us to process our data securely and at speed. We have now moved several workloads to OCI Lakehouse. This has allowed us to accelerate and move workloads from Hadoop and Spark on our data centers and other cloud providers to OCI Lakehouse. I can port over with some transformation, and I can be up and running on Lakehouse without having to re-engineer, re-architect, and it's significant cost and time. We have moved our call center reporting. We have moved financial analytics. We've moved some of fraud detection systems. And we've also migrated some of our credit scores in Brazil to OCI Lakehouse. In the first workloads that we benchmarked, we saw a 40% increase in performance and a 60% cost reduction. We've had the same outcome in every single instance. We have increased performance, increased reliability, increased resilience, and reduced cost. This was significant for regions that need to process large amounts of data, but don't have the same financial resources that other regions have. We strongly believe what Oracle has with Lakehouse and Oracle Cloud Infrastructure is a game changer. It's the next generation of cloud. It allows us to transform faster. It allows us to increase our performance. It allows us to reduce cost. But most importantly, it allows us to have a bigger impact on society. We can process data faster. In emerging markets, we can bring new products in. We can change the entrepreneur ecosystem that powers those economies. You will get that back tenfold if you get it right up front. That is very exciting to have a partner like Oracle to help us do that.
All right, very exciting to hear about what Merv and his team are doing at Experian. That's just a great example of getting started on your Lakehouse journey by leveraging existing investments that you've already made on the big data path. Let's talk about the next path that we see customers moving toward a Lakehouse on, and that is modernizing their data warehouse. What we want in OCI is for every data warehouse to become a Lakehouse. So you can analyze all types of data, the relational data and the non-relational data together. And our goal is to make this entirely transparent to your applications. So for years, Oracle's Autonomous Data Warehouse has enabled customers to write SQL joins across their data warehouse and data lake data. So if you have data in the relational tables, you have data in object storage, you can bridge the two. So we're doing a lot to make that both faster, more scalable, and also easier. Let's talk about that a little bit. So Autonomous Data Warehouse has a new query offload technology, gives you more CPUs, more parallelism, and more network channels when you're accessing your data lake in OCI object storage. So you can put together queries that combine OCI object storage, relational data in a single SQL statement, but bridge both worlds, and you can do it with much greater efficiency than you've been able to do in the past. This lets organizations analyze all their data from the data warehouse to the data lake faster, more easily, better results for their users, right? And also, second thing we're doing here is to make it easier to write the SQL that covers both the warehouse and the data lake within the Lakehouse architecture. We've integrated Autonomous Data Warehouse with the OCI data catalog, so you can discover, understand, and query all the tables within the Lakehouse easily. So it's a single catalog for the Lakehouse, covers what's in the relational systems, what's in the non-relational data lake aspects of the Lakehouse architecture, all within a single catalog. Okay, so let's look at a customer example. MindSense, this innovative ISV, they use machine learning and advanced sensors together to optimize mining operations. So MindSense puts these sensors on these huge power shovels, then they send terabytes of IoT data to their OCI Lakehouse. And it helps them to identify high-grade ore in real time. OCI's Lakehouse, with the new SQL query acceleration capabilities within the Autonomous Data Warehouse, gave MindSense 5 times better query performance with no changes at all to their SQL, no changes to their applications. It's a great example of how you can take a warehouse and turn it into a lakehouse simply, transparently, and quickly. Now, the last path that we wanted to highlight for how to get started building a lakehouse is to get more out of your application data, right? So our customers at Oracle have data and data models that they use to solve their common business problems today, right? It's in their business applications, it's in our SaaS portfolio, it's in their own bespoke applications. But we have got a series of lakehouse investments that I'd like to talk about that make it easier to join that application together with other sources of data from external systems and bring them together to discover new ways to drive your business. So for example, you can use the lakehouse to join community health information that comes from news, media, and clinical notes together with patient data. So you could understand who's at risk for readmission, or you could forecast where you're gonna see a spike in demand for care, right? So you can take predictive measures preemptively. Lots of different ways you can pull this data together from within your applications and within other data sources to better understand your business. The OCI Lakehouse architecture supports any kind of application, third party, homegrown, whatever, together with our Oracle Fusion Cloud applications. You can extract data from them, you can do advanced analytics, all within the Lakehouse context. So one of the things we're introducing today are enhanced tools to make it easier to build your lakehouse on OCI with SaaS application data and data models, right? So we have a new OCI data integration service, Fusion Connector, which lets you easily extract SaaS data from your SaaS application, your Fusion SaaS application, into the lakehouse. We also have OCI's Golden Gate service, which lets you keep application and lakehouse data in sync in real time. So in this same workflow, our AI services can be used to enrich the data with pre-built and custom trained models that are already in line with the SaaS models and the SaaS application metadata. Now, let's take a quick look at another example. Here's how Ingersoll Rand has co-located their applications and their data on OCI, and how they're using a lakehouse as the single source of truth to drive their business.
Ingersoll Rand is a premier industrial company with more than 40 brands. We operate in over 50 countries and serve a very diverse set of customers. Our strategic goal is to grow our business and our talent in a sustainable and profitable way. My team is designated to advance Ingersoll Rand's strategy, and our mission is to enable actionable insights throughout the organization. Our company has had multiple mergers and acquisitions over the last few years, and we operate under 5 different business units. That means our data is just a little bit messy. We want to be able to combine data from our legacy companies and those legacy systems to reflect the company as it is today. And that means combining data from numerous ERPs, legacy data warehouses, connected products, and a slew of other source systems. We need to be able to execute incremental loads and improve data availability. And we also need row-level security. Today, we can't limit data access based on role, so we've had to restrict access to fewer users to prevent any concerns around privacy or security. We decided to move to Oracle Cloud to help achieve our goals. The OCI Lakehouse addresses our goals because it provides a path to converge those legacy data warehouses and reporting platforms to move us closer to that one version of truth. I also really want a reporting platform for users with standard reports without the need for extra ETL or visualization tools. Oracle Cloud provided a unified platform for applications, data, and infrastructure. We chose OCI for greater efficiency and really a clearer migration path. We moved our eBusiness Suite ERP and replaced our aging on-premise Cloudera environment. We're in the process of consolidating multiple BI tools. Plus, going forward, we can better utilize that IoT machine data to understand trends, prevent failures, and improve the customer experience. Overall, the partnership with Oracle has been great. The big data migration to the cloud was executed ahead of schedule, and we moved hundreds of terabytes of data in 5 months. We're already seeing some of the benefits. We're delivering insights on time to the business, and I've received positive feedback from end users already about how much faster this new environment is. The bottom line, Ingersoll Rand needs data for advanced analytics. We need advanced analytics to deliver on our strategy, especially around accelerating growth. The OCI Lakehouse helps provide the right foundation to achieve that.
All right, very exciting. Great to see the progress that Ingersoll Rand is making with their Lakehouse journey. So we've talked about enterprises. We talked about an ISV. Let's also talk about a key system integrator partner. Accenture is a global professional services company. It's serving clients in 120 countries, and it's a leader in applied intelligence and analytics. They built two new customer solutions supported by OCI's Lakehouse technology: the Intelligent Data Platform and the Accenture Workplace Accountability Resource Experience. They chose OCI because it helps them quickly collect data from many sources, like Oracle Fusion Human Capital Management, right? A great example of using the technologies to access data within the Fusion SaaS environment and with other applications. So with this solution, they can securely manage their data, improve data quality, and get many kinds of industry-specific benefits for their clients. So for example, they're using a data lakehouse on OCI to help their clients improve inclusion, diversity, and equity within their organizations, which is a very popular kind of key workload for many enterprises today. So Oracle has years of experience understanding the most routine and important problems that face your business. So whether it's automating risk or fraud detection, creating personalized experience for your customers, we know the data and the data models you need to solve those problems. As we move forward with the Lakehouse product plans, we're going to continue to accelerate our ability to bring that knowledge directly into the Lakehouse. So we'll give you all the starting data, the data models, and the AI models, the trained AI models that you need to get important and differentiated outcomes for your business from those data sets. Since we already know the raw data artifacts you need, we can innovate by automating how they come together to get you the right outcomes that you're looking for. Most importantly, we can make sure it's easy for you to publish and consume these insights directly within your Oracle Cloud applications and solutions. So, three key takeaways about the Lakehouse on OCI. One is that you can analyze any kind of data from any database, any application, no matter where it originates from. You can bring it into the Lakehouse and get value, right? We can store, understand, and analyze all types of data, and you can accelerate your solutions, whether you're starting from scratch or with an existing data warehouse and data lake. We can help you get quickly to a modern Lakehouse architecture on OCI. So to get started on OCI, first of all, please visit oracle.com/lakehouse. You'll find out a bunch of information there. You'll see common patterns, best practices, and you'll learn about the services and updates we announced today. One thing that I wanted to highlight today is you can get started with a free trial right now. You can learn more about our programs and incentives, which make it very easy to move to OCI. So I want to thank you for joining us today. And I want to also ask you to stay after the keynote. We have got a live question and answer session with our OCI experts, and we have a number of technical demos coming up to help you get started with building your Lakehouse on OCI, which is absolutely the best place to build your first or your next Lakehouse.